of music. Each Monday, we welcome another artist to share some songs and stories as the Nicole Sandler Show presents the Monday Music Sunset Sessions.
Ah, well, it took a little doing, but we're here, and I'm thrilled to welcome Marvin Etzioni to the show. Now, Marvin and I go way, way, way back. Haven't seen each other in probably over 20 years until just recently.
Does time go backwards for you? How does that happen? You look 20 years younger.
Right.
What happened? Yeah. How'd you do that?
Music. It's rock and roll keeps me
okay.
young.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
So Marvin Etzioni is a founding member of the legendary LA-based band Lone Justice.
I've heard of them.
It's been a while since you and Maria made music, but your Lone Justice lives on. Marvin is gone.
What's really interesting about Lone Justice, in the last 2 or 3 years, I don't know if you know about this, Nicole, but I in 1983, before I joined the band, I had produced some recordings, and Omnivore Recordings put them out as an EP. And literally over 35 years later, just in the last year, Rolling Stone put one of the songs that I wrote, Working Late, in their new songs, top 10 songs to look at. And they had all the other artists were contemporary artists.
And they had an old song of yours.
Yeah, and so I kind of think that that's what Lone Justice represents. Like, this is, you know, like if a brand new band came out and sounded just like Lone Justice did in 1983, they would do really good.
I guess so, because some music is timeless. You know, some of it is very dated, but some of it is timeless, and I find that the really good music is timeless. So Marvin Etzioni, in the years since Lone Justice, you've been making your own music. You're also known as the Mandolin Man. You've been producing others' music. You've been keeping busy all these years, and you've got a brand new album out. Called What's the Mood of the Country Now? Right? Do I have that right?
You got it.
What's the Mood of the Country Now? And it's a perfect record for the times we're living in. But actually, you wrote that title track back right after 9/11, didn't you?
That's correct. Yeah. My note to myself was I called it 9/13, you know, because I wrote it 2 days after 9/11. And that really was the catalyst. It's like, you know, I really need to work on a record that has a political overtone to it. But it took me all these years to kind of culminate them, and it was the right thing at the right time, you know. So I'm excited about the results this weekend. And, I had banked everything on this record for this weekend.
Here you go.
But I hope that, you know, no matter... I have to be honest that I know friends of mine that didn't vote.
Really?
One friend of mine voted for a third party for JoJo.
Oh, God.
And so whether you've over almost 40% of the people in the country didn't vote. And so my message is no matter who you voted for and if you didn't vote, it's about the music. It's about the songs and it's about the time, the timelessness of it, and that's what the connection is about.
Well, first of all, let me just say, to those who didn't vote, you should have voted. And if you voted for a third party candidate, I was going to play something else. If you voted for a third party candidate, then I have a little song for you. It goes something like this, Marvin.
First of all,
whoops. No, it goes like this. I'm a little slow on the uptake today, but okay, you know, because right. There was so much at stake. I guess the good news is it looks like we're getting rid of Donald Trump. But seriously, I don't know how anyone could sit this one out or not be involved, or worse yet, vote for the Orange Menace. There's so much at stake with this election, and we really, the Democrats did us no favors. They did not win. This was not a landslide for the Democrats. This was a mandate to get rid of Donald Trump, but the Democrats didn't pick up seats in the House or win back the Senate, there's a chance we could tie.
Well,
but
we'll find out. Yeah.
You know, but you know, I think this is everyone's duty. Anyway, I bemoan the fact constantly that there's really not a lot of great protest music out there. I wouldn't call this record, What's the Mood of the Country Now, a protest record, but it does tap into everything we've been feeling for the last, not only 4 years, but really since 9/11. So I'll tell you what, Marvin Etzioni's with us. I want to play a song while we're still on Progressive Voices so that the people there get to hear it. And then stick around because we'll do a little bit of overtime. If anyone wants to stick with us, come to NicoleSandler.com or just listen at NicoleSandlerStream.com. But in the meantime, let's listen to a song from the new album from Marvin Etzioni, What's the Mood of the Country Now? And this one, you want to tell us a little bit about Here Comes America?
Well, Here Comes America, I started writing that song during the Iraq War. And it was, I wanted to create a positive protest song. And what the last line I wrote for the song was without war in your eyes. And that's really what I hope for all of us on how we can get through these times. And so many people have heard the song and responded as if I'd written it for what exactly we're going through right now. I'm glad that it's being taken that way. I just got an email yesterday that it just went number one on a UK chart.
Nice.
Which is exciting. And you know, so the response has been great on the song, and a special shout out to my friend Cy Smith, who sings the song with me, who's such a brilliant singer and artist in her own right. And just real quick, Don Heffington on drums and David Leach on percussion, and Zach Baird and my right hand Adam Pike for the mix. And we did the vocals with my friend Jeff Peters. So I'm just surrounded. And Mike Bosey, who mastered Kendrick Lamar, he mastered the album. Mm-hmm. So it's such a great team, a beautiful collection of people. And so that's Here Comes America.
Let's listen to it. Here Comes America, Marvin Etzioni on the Nicole Sandler Show. Whoops, we're going to do it. Actually, let me do this.
Okay.
Oh, my goodness. And we'll play it from here. Here we go. All right. It away, Marvin.
Here comes America. The one we've been waiting for, my friend. Here comes America. Future of freedom is in your hands.
I wish I could go along for the ride
and keep my mouth shut,
but I'm not willing to pay the price.
On the damage that's been done with that war in your eyes.
Here comes America. We've been waiting for, my friend. Here comes America. The future of freedom is in your hands, in your hands. Whatever you dream,
you can do. Begin it now. With your heart. Mm-hmm.
mind.
With your love, begin it now.
Marvin Etzioni.
All right.
Here Comes America. From the new album, What's the Mood in the Country Now? That sounds great, Marvin. Really good.
Thank you. Yeah.
So we're gonna try to do this. We're going to chat, around the end of the show on Mondays.
Okay.
We'll talk. We'll see what's happening in the world. There is a connection. There is a coming together between the world of music and art and politics, because it's life, it's what we're living, and it's important that we all stay. I think the reason that people don't vote is because they're not involved. They think it doesn't affect them, and actually what our elected officials do affects every aspect of our lives. Tomorrow, in case you didn't know, tomorrow is November 10th. The Supreme Court is hearing the Trump administration's challenge to the Affordable Care Act. Because they haven't taken enough insurance away from people yet, they're going tomorrow to argue before the Supreme Court that what's left of it should be overturned. Now, as somebody who's self-employed and a cancer survivor, this is the only way I have health insurance. Without the Affordable Care Act, I'm uninsurable. So much is on the line. So much is on the line with this election. And now we're dealing with the consequences of it. And I just hope that Amy Coney Barrett, who the Republicans again shoved through the Supreme Court at literally the 11th hour, could be the key to making sure we don't have health insurance when there's a global pandemic going on.
Yeah, we have an opportunity that just because the politicians aren't talking about music, sometimes the artists have to talk about politics for a moment.
Absolutely.
And encourage each other. Please register to vote and be ready for the next election, because it's coming up.
Well, we're there. January 5th, because the next election is the runoff, two runoffs in Georgia.
That's right.
That will determine the balance of power in the Senate.
In Georgia.
Which means if the two Democrats win those races on January 5th in Georgia, then it'll be, I believe, a 50-50 tie, which means the party, the vice president is the tiebreaker. With Kamala Harris as vice president, the Democrats have a majority in the Senate, will be able to get stuff done, will be able to deal with climate change, will be able to deal with health care, will be able to deal with COVID, will be able to get relief. But if the Republicans retain control of the Senate and Mitch McConnell calls the shots, we're screwed.
Well, tell you what, first couple of people that get in touch with you, I'll send them a promo CD if they promise that they're going to register to vote. But this is only for people in Georgia. If you're listening in Georgia.
I think anybody listening to this show is already registered to vote.
Okay, I hope so.
If you want to give away a couple of CDs, we can do that, though. So say the first two people who send me an email, Nicole at NicoleSandler.com, Marvin will send you a copy of the new CD.
I'll write a note of thank you.
Awesome.
To you, and thanks for listening to Nicole's show. We do go back a ways, and it's so great to reconnect with you. And I'm so glad that we're aligned politically and musically and philosophically. It's so fantastic.
You and me both. I want to get into in coming weeks, we'll both, play more songs from the record.
Okay.
and talk about, some of the artists you've worked with and what they're doing.
Right.
And I know there's a lot of stuff happening now. And right now is a really tough time for musicians because there's no touring right now.
Yeah.
So,
right.
We got to find a way to keep you guys occupied and making money.
Sounds good.
All right. Marvin Etzioni, great to see you. I'll talk to you next week.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay, bye.
Adios.
Bye. And then, for everybody else, tomorrow, with